Tonight we begin a four-part series, Made in Arizona. We'll look at four things that are made in our state that might surprise you. We begin with a close look at how something we all need is pumped out of the ground in Glendale. Producer Larry Lemmons and videographer Richard Torruellas take us back to the salt mine.
Mining process at the Morton Salt Glendale salt mine is a solution mining process in which we create a brine well. And the brine well is a series of pipes that you see here in which we inject water down into the formation, dissolve the salt, and bring up the salt water or brine into the solar ponds. And once in the ponds, the sun and the wind evaporate the water from the salt, leaving us a salt floor, and it leaves a cake of salt on the floor that we then harvest. I don't know if you can see the crystals are floating on the pond right now, showing that as the wind kicks up, the crystals will fall down, create this layer of salt on the floor in which we harvest. Here is Morton salt. It's not table salt. It's not used on your french fries. Used mainly for water softening, water conditioning. And there's over 14,000 uses of salt. One of our big users here in Arizona is the Arizona Nuclear Power Project, and they use it in their water reclamation system to generate chlorine for their sanitization of the water. Right over here is a harvester. And what he does is he cuts through that layer of salt and pumps a slurry, which is brine and salt crystals, up to our wash plant where it's further processed. And he has a laser level on the side of the pond and a receiver there so he knows just how much to cut, whether it's 6 inches, 12 inches, depending on the growth. Because once we get the salt into the ponds here, Mother Nature evaporates the water from the salt, creating that salt layer.
The facility here is located on the Luke Salt Body, and the Luke Salt Body encompasses anywhere from 15 to 30 cubic miles. We're located here where we hit salt about 900 feet below surface. There's been drilling down to about 7,000 feet, and we're in a solid mass of salt. Once the harvester has harvested the salt, he pumps the salt up to the top, or his slurry up to the top of the wash plant. And he's pumping brine or salt water and crystals, salt crystals, through. So it hits the top there, goes through dewatering screens where the salt crystals drop down into a classifier and then into the stockpile. And then the water brine is pumped into our reclaim pit and reclaimed and processed back to the system. And once it hits the stockpile, it has about 20% moisture where it sits and drains for 3 or 4 days till it has on the average about 4% moisture. Then we take it with a front-end loader and feed it into our rotary kiln to dry or flash off that 4% moisture so we can screen it and then process through and bag. It goes through a screening process and is screened into our three different grades. We have one that's a pellet grade, a coarse grade, and a fine grade. The pellet grade goes into our system saver pellets, and the coarse and the fine grade are loose crystals that are bagged into the bag. So I'll take the loose crystals from the hoppers underneath the building, the dried salt, with front end loader, drop it into the hopper where it's weighed through there and then sealed through the heat seal and out through the palletize. Once they palletize it, they take it to the stretch wrapper. It's stretch wrapped and palletized, either stored in the warehouse or loaded into the trucks. We distribute to all the grocery stores out here, do some private label, and distribute to most of the areas in Arizona and Southern California.
Joining us now to tell us more about the Morton Salt Glendale facility, the facility manager, Michelle Jones. Michelle, there were a lot of tidbits in there, some apparently more to spice things up, forgive the pun, than anything else. But tell us how the facility was first established. So we flashed up a few dates on there, but give us some more details.
The facility was actually discovered 1952 by accident. Goodyear Farms was drilling for a water well, drilled a little bit too deep, around 900 feet, and hit salt. And it wasn't discovered or acted upon until a few years later in 1968 when the first well was dug, and then Southwest Salt began, and Morton acquired Southwest Salt in 1985.
And when you were going over the map in the video package, the indication is it's quite a bit of salt. How much?
They estimate anywhere from 15 to 30 cubic miles. They're not sure. Like I said, we hit salt where we're at, about 900 feet below surface, and there's been drilling to 7,000 feet, and we're still in salt, the solid mass of salt. So I have job security.
Well, and from some discussions we had off the air, it's job security for you and for your descendants for millennia.
For quite a while. There's a lot of salt there.
And tell me again how much we're talking about. I think you indicate thousands of years worth
probably
of salt.
Probably thousands of years if they develop the whole area that's around there. For us, hundreds of years.
Now, we live in a desert, but this is evidence, I assume, that once we were underwater?
At one time, that was evidence we were once underwater. There had to be an ocean here at one time to make this larger deposit.
What are the different ways that salt can be mined?
There are actually three ways. The worst, when you think of a salt mine, is the mine you think of anything, especially out here, copper mining or that type of thing. You think of somewhere coal mine, going underground, blasting out the surface. And they do that in the salt mines. They go underground, they set the fire and the ammunition, and they blow out.
But not here?
Not here. Yeah. The closest one to us is Grand Saline, Texas. And then they mine that out, bring that up in the skips, just like a regular mining. The other is what we call evaporation. And that's where they take it, where they create a brine well, just like we do at our plant that you saw, piping and that type of thing. They create that brine well, bring up the brine, but instead of going to a solar pond like we do here, they take it to what's called a vacuum pan. And in that vacuum pan, they drive the water off as steam, leaving the salt. And this is where most of your food grade comes from.
Michelle, as I understand it, this is the only operation of its kind in Arizona. But tell us quickly, what other significant salt sites are there in the country and around the world?
There are salt sites all over the world. Salt is a very heavy commodity, and we're fortunate there's salt everywhere around, because otherwise trucking would be very expensive to take it from here back to the east for road ice control. So there's a lot of salt all through the world. There's lots of salt facilities throughout the U.S. and Canada.
And now we know that Arizona is